Now she's in the air doing these stunts, and it's like, yay, go team. Like it.
What makes this heart beat faster? Love tomorrow.
Hey honeys, it's your boy Jeremiah back again with another video. And in today's video, I'll be reacting to Good For You by Olivia Rodrigo. Now, I previously reacted to Olivia Rodrigo, which I will link in the card above if you want to check that out. And I've sung my praises over Driver's License over and over again. I absolutely love Deja Vu as well. I think it was a second grade single. This is the third single from her debut album, Sour, so I'm super excited to see what this is like. I also am considering reacting to the album as well because this girl has been on a roll with the music lately. I heard a small portion of the song in her album trailer video towards the end. She gave us a small snippet, so I kind of know what the song sounds like, what it's about in its most basic sense, but I'm super excited to get into the music video as well as the full song in its entirety. But before we get into this video, make sure you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, hit that bell icon for notifications for what I post every week, not every 2 weeks, not every 3 weeks, every 7 days or less, honey. And without further ado, let's get into the music video. What is that, the new Samsung? Oh, Samsung, you have the Z Flip phone. I see you with your little sponsorships, Olivia.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? Good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you should really help. Now you could be a better man for your brand new girl.
Gasoline and popcorn. Okay, let me start off by saying this. I love the fact that she's exploring different sounds already within this album. Because to me personally, Deja Vu and Driver's License kind of seem like they were going in the same notes when it comes to like the sound. You know, very more mellow, very more chill, very more acoustic-ish type of songs. This one is the total opposite. It's very instrument heavy. You know, we have this guitar, electric guitar, really taking the lead of the melody. And you know, there's you know, some synthetic elements in there as well, which I absolutely enjoy in the song. Now, what I will say is, I'm not quite as impressed with this song as I am with the other two. I enjoy the melody, I enjoy the song, but now I think at this point, the theme of the songs are very repetitive. You know, Olivia Rodrigo is a supremely talented girl. She's a supremely beautiful girl. But what I'm seeing here is we're getting stuck in this theme, and a lot of people describe Taylor Swift this way too, which I think she's been able to jump herself out of. But we're seeing this constant theme of heartbreak, and I don't know. I feel like, you know, even when it comes to like I feel like heartbreak as a theme is so overused already. There's only so many ways that you can iterate it to make it sound fresh and new and different. Three songs, I think, is enough. Me personally, three songs within the album, I think, is enough. So, you know, at this moment, I'm not entirely tired of the theme of heartbreak and not getting over somebody and, you know, things of that sort. But we already had Driver's License. We already had Deja Vu. Now, this is the third one. Now, I think this music video perfectly describes the song because, you know, you basically... this guy is moving on from this relationship and she has it. And you can see it in like her daily activity. She's, you know, in the locker room. She's doing her hair and makeup. She's a cheerleader. And you can see that she's very empathetic to everything else going on to her in her life because she's going through this heartbreak. You know, she's in the air doing these stunts and it's like, yay, go team. Like she's very empathetic of the situation because she's still not over this heartbreak. So she can't really get back to her daily life. I think this music video perfectly describes the theme of this song, and I think it was perfectly executed. With everything considered, I would give this an 8 out of 10. I think it's still a great song. I think the theme of these songs coming from her need to change from something other than heartbreak or not getting over a guy, definitely, because there's more to life than boys, you know? Romance has its good parts. Romance has its sour parts. I'd love to see a song maybe about the sweet parts of love in this album, or a song about, you know, having fun with the girls in this album, or, you know, a song about something other than being heartbroken. I know she's perfectly capable of writing a good song about something other than heartbreak, and I know that she's going to deliver some bangers when it comes to this album, so I'm super excited to hear what else she has in store for us. But that is all for this video, guys. Make sure you like this video. Give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that bell icon for notification when I post. I post every week. Not every 2 weeks. Not every 3 weeks. Every 7 days or less, honey. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, honey.